In this video, we're going to look at unit conversions between the metric and the English system. In order to convert between metric and English, we need to know what the equivalences are, the relationships. You might have to memorize these. As you do your homework, you're just going to want to keep a table handy. This is a typical table that shows the relationships between the metric and the English system. You can find a bazillion of these on the internet. One thing that you do want to watch when you find these equivalences, these relationships between a metric unit and an English unit, is you want a relationship that has at least three sig figs for the equivalence. One is exact, but the 2.205 then has four sig figs. You want something that has at least three sig figs for that equivalence. If you go shorter than that, then it's going to introduce error into your answer. So you want to find equivalences with at least three sig figs. This is a table that we find in our textbook. For the first problem we want to work, we want to convert 4.26 kilograms. We want to convert that into pounds. The metric prefix, or the metric unit of kilograms, we want to change it into the English unit of pounds. We're going to set up this conversion problem just like we've been doing all of our other unit conversion problems. How many pounds equals 4.26 kilograms times in your ratio sign? And then you bring your units down here so that it cancels. Always do your units first. Kilograms has to cancel. It has to be here. I'd like to put pounds on top because that's what I need, and I can as long as I have a relationship or an equivalence between kilograms and pounds, and I do. So I'll put my pound unit on top, and I'll use this relationship to write my numbers. The 1 goes with the kilogram, the 2.205 goes with the pound unit, 2.205. My kilogram unit cancels, and I punch this into my calculator. Careful about this being my unit. I'll punch in 4.26 times 2.205. I can hit divided by 1 if I want to, but I don't have to. And then my calculator will display the answer, and it will display something like this. I'll see 9.3933. That is the answer before we round it, but when we're multiplying and dividing, we want to round our answer to whoever has the shortest number of sig figs. I see 3 sig figs in this number, 3 sig figs, the 4.26. I had 4 sig figs in my conversion factor. That's why I don't want to go really less than 3 sig figs in my conversion factor. I don't want it to limit my sig figs. So I'm going to go 3 sig figs, the shorter of the two, for my answer. And so I will report my answer as 9.39 pounds. All right, let's work another one. How about we convert 65.3 grams into pounds? A very similar problem, except for we want to start with grams. Our equivalence table, our relationships between the metric and English system, relates pounds to kilograms. It doesn't relate pounds to grams, so this might take more than one step. I'm still going to start the problem exactly the same. How many pounds, that's what I'm trying to find, equals 65.3 grams, and I'll still draw my multiplication sign and my ratio, and I will still put my grams unit on bottom. But now I'm not going to put my pounds unit on top because I don't have a direct relationship between grams and pounds. I have to recognize that to get to pounds, I need kilograms. So I'm going to need two steps going through kilograms, and once I get the kilograms, then I can go to pounds. This can come from my prefix table. Actually, they've gone ahead and listed it down here. From my prefix table for kilo, I would see 10 to the third or 1,000. That's the number of the base unit, so 1,000 grams equals 1 kilogram. And my grams unit cancels, and now I need another step with my kilograms on the bottom, units, units, units. That has to go there to cancel, and I'll put my pound unit on top. And now I can use this relationship between kilograms and pounds. A 1 goes with the kilogram, the 2.205 goes with the pounds. My kilograms cancels. I punch that into my calculator, and it tells me something like this. 0.143985. That's before I round it. I'm not going to report all those digits as my answer. As I look at these numbers, I have three sig figs. I have three sig figs in this number. I have this 1 to the 1,000 is exact, and I have four sig figs in my conversion, and so I'm going to round my answer to three sig figs. Remember that that 0 doesn't count as a sig fig, it's just a placeholder, and so I'll report 0.144, rounding up, pounds as my answer.